Waar is die geldmagnate? Waar lê die rykdomme van die vaderland? Mandela wil nie 16% aan die volk gee. Hy is nie tevrede met 86%. Hy, voorzitter, maak soos Kalipien en Zulkaats. Hy wil nie vrede, hy wil oorlog hê. As hy oorlog wil hê, dan sal hy oorlog kry.
I'd made a film about the leader in 1991, but Eugene and I just never got on.
Stop it.
Eugene and his followers so disliked me after this film came out that I received a whole bunch of death threats and a threat to bomb my flat. I never imagined in my worst nightmares that 14 years later, I'd feel compelled to track down his big white self. You might well think that Eugene and the Afrikaner resistance movement look like something out of Dad's army, but behind the beer bellies and badly trimmed beards, there existed a sinister force that would not be proudly displayed in South Africa's history books. Between 91, when I'd last seen them, and the present day, the AWB caused death and destruction and largely got away with it. Other than blacks, the leader most disliked foreign journalists. He said I looked like a Turk and should be put in the colored section of town.
Excuse me, Mr. Terre'Blanche.
Yes.
I'm sorry about the, you know, mix-up last
night. Listen, my good friend. This is the last time that when of your purple, I don't mind whether it's a woman or not, be cheeky with me. You understand it? This is my country, this is my place. This is my day. And last night I said I don't want your people anymore here. This morning you have to speak to me, and the first thing you do is to take photos from me. Before you even ask me if you are welcome or not.
Okay.
And this man, I sit in Fender's dog. I tell you people when he can take shots from us. But he's like a bloody monkey. He's hanging on that camera like a monkey in a bloody tree.
He is a monkey. You are a monkey. He definitely is.
My original film was called The Leader, the Driver, and the Driver's Wife. This is JP, the driver.
How are you doing? Fine, thank you. Just tired. Well, I saw him shitting you out. Apparently, he just doesn't like your face today.
And this is Anita, the driver's wife.
He wants to show the state president that they would like their schools to be white.
This one's also so. What's your Marcus about the school?
Yeah, he'll eat the black when he comes to this school.
That's what he says.
Yeah.
And what did the girls say?
Anyway, back to the present, it's summer 2005, and the reason I'm here is the leader is just out of prison. As I was the last person in the world Eugene would want to talk to, I thought Rita, my producer, might have a better chance of an interview.
Would like to do an interview with us.
But I said no, lady, please, in God's name, I said no, I am not willing to give you an interview at this stage after the 6th of December, but not now. Please don't press me to put down this telephone. Listen to me, I'm not going to give you an interview. Do we understand each other? Please don't it to me. Because I love people and I like ladies like you more than the usual people. But don't press me to be rude. Okay, goodbye. Okay.
We drove from Johannesburg to Ventersdorp in the Old Transvaal, where the AWB have their headquarters and where both the leader and JP have their houses. We would eventually get to the leader after much scheming and plotting. The leader was on parole until December the 6th and forbidden to do political interviews and meetings. This is JP's house. JP was, if you remember, in prison for having enough high explosives to demolish an entire city block. And I'm pretty sure JP left me one of the death threats.
We've been talking together about getting JP a new job and house away from tobacco. And I'm hoping we're not pushing.
I was surprised to find my film playing with only JP's dog watching.
Well, he's obviously really interested in this film.
Yeah, you were going through a really and that you felt very disillusioned, both with the leader and with Putin.
Hey, Nick.
We noticed that the film wasn't having a big impression on you.
Which one?
My film, because you've left it. You left it playing while you have a shave.
This is about the third time. Just switch that thing off. This is about the third time that I've watched it now.
The third time.
I was really trying to find something to hit you with, but there's nothing left.
So what do you
just
think?
Just switch it off.
What do you think of it?
I think it's a nice film.
You like it?
I enjoy it. Switch off that thing, please.
So why were you so complaining about it the last time?
One thing I'm quite sure of, I'd pick my targets better.
Well, what kind of targets would you go for?
Well, the enemies of our folk. The people that are at the moment, very moment, busy selling out our people.
Like who?
Well, I can't at the moment think of any names, but if you want to mention names, maybe people like Flock and FW and Mandela, all the enemies of our folk, and even people from outside our country that want to poke their long noses into our affairs. I'm not sure. I haven't got any targets. But I feel the climate is beginning to be ripe for human life to be taken.
Sorry, man, I didn't expect you to be so early.
Greta Garbo dresses.
Did you sleep last night?
I think Greta Garbo gets up quicker than you, JP.
Certainly. Why don't we have a seat?
What a charming sight.
Yeah. Oh, doch, okay, Tiki. Shall I put her away, Nick, in the bedroom there?
Did you feel I'd let you down? Because I think when the film was finished and you first saw it here, you were very, very angry with me.
I won't say I was very angry. I was slightly upset. But I won't say I was very angry. I wouldn't have killed you.
Well, didn't
you? I wouldn't have left death threats on your phone.
Because
if that's the type of thing you are aiming for,
no,
it wasn't me.
You didn't leave some death threats.
No, I really didn't. I promise you, I never did.
Because it sounded...
It's not my style. Would have been much better for me to hold a knife against your throat now than leaving death threats on your phone. I will never do that. You'd rather have arranged for a bomb to explode near your place than leave a death threat. I think that's a bigger death threat than anything else.
Well, there was, on one of the death threats, there was mention of a bomb.
There was never arranged, was it?
Well, clearly the bomb didn't work. Most of the AWB bombs didn't work.
Yeah, I think they worked quite well. They worked quite well. They were intended not to kill. But those that killed worked just as well as the other ones. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's anything into making a bomb and exploding a bomb. It's easy as pie.
We traveled from Ventersdorp to Ottersdal to visit Anita. JP and Anita are now divorced. This is Ottersdal, a remote town in the old Transvaal. I hadn't seen Anita for 14 years. Hello! God, you look
Hello.
Well.
Hello.
How are you? I see you. Kaffer cat.
Anita, if you remember from the old film, is of Kaffer cat fame.
Why do you call it Kaffer cat?
Because it's black. The blacks are called Kaffers here. So, Yanni wants to call it Blackie or something like that. So I said, ach no, every singing dog or cat you get in town that's black are called Blackie. Let's be different and call it Kaffir Cat. So I think it's a marvellous idea.
So do you think you'll name your next cat Kaffir Cat?
No, I don't know. I will have a Persian cat next time with a flat face. And it depends on its personality. Kaffir Cat finish life with his name.
So you've been through a lot of changes since we saw you last time.
Oh, the divorce was the worst one.
With JP.
Yeah. I never thought it will happen to me in all my life. And, but I suppose we just grew away from one another.
Hmm.
I was for a long time still trying to keep him, but he didn't want to. So we were moving then to this place, then he kicked me out, then he said, now I can stay in the house and he will stay in the little house, then we move again.
And do you think he was very disillusioned by Eugene Terre'Blanche?
I think most of the people who was in the AWB are a bit sad, but we are 1 to 11, I think, at this stage. 44 million blacks and only 4 million whites. So how can you balance? You can't really balance, so you will lose. That's something that you need to accept. The only thing that still keep us going is our religion. And if you believe that in the afterlife and that you will have a nice place in heaven, then you're still satisfied.
The last time I'd been in Ventersdorp, you would hardly see a black face. Blacks had to stay in the township unless they were working. But today, the centre is buzzing with an African market. Ventersdorp was the headquarters for the far-right wing. In 91, shortly after we left, Ventersdorp hit national news when de Klerk, the state president, came to visit. The leader regarded him as a traitor to the white race and organized a mass protest. It was to be the first time in the 43 years of apartheid that white police killed white demonstrators. Later on, the AWB cut the electricity and people were blindly firing into the night. The leader and the AWB were experts in disrupting rival political meetings. They've been doing it since the 1980s. The ruling National Party were called Kaffir lovers because they took down the apartheid signs and started negotiating with Mandela and the ANC.
I thought it was going to lead to a revolution because I was promised a revolution, which never came.
But in fact,
if you train a horse to to ride a race, and you don't give him a race to ride, you break his spirit. And I have a good idea. This is what happened to me. I was told the revolution was that same night that the ANC takes over. It's going to be war in South Africa. And I expected war. I didn't get war. I was quite surprised. But what we got, I think, is much worse than war, because war starts and it's not long, then it's over. This thing is going to last for a while, and the eventual outcome of it be more or less the same.
I remember how defiant JP was after his release from prison.
They won't arrest me again. I won't allow them. They'll have to kill me. I'm sleeping with a Luger right next to me.
Would you seriously use it?
Yes, I don't think I'll try seriously to kill somebody. But I'll definitely make a lot of noise and force them to shoot me. That I'll do.
In 93, the leader and the AWB stormed the World Trade Center in Johannesburg, where the ANC National Party and others were meeting to discuss an election date. The white police, army and special forces offered no protection and walked away as the AWB approached.
They look like they're invading the place.
Blanche and the Afrikaner people thought of this as the start of the white Christian people's struggle against black majority rule. It marked the beginning of a campaign of enormous violence and carnage. General Constant Vignon, former head of the South African Army and leader of the Volksfront, a coalition of right-wing groups. The leader's alliance with General Vignon and the Volksfront gave the AWB a credibility it had been lacking and a strong power base. But Vignon disapproved of Terre'Blanche's more violent and thuggish methods. Mandela, for the first time, threatened to bring in the ANC military wing for protection. He felt that the white police were inadequate.
I have already indicated to Mr. de Klerk, when I spoke to him this morning, that unless action which we will regard as effective, I will have no alternative but to arm Umkhonto and ask them to come and defend and negotiate us here.
But people just loved the leader's simple solution of immediate violence. At their peak, the AWB had 500,000 supporters.
Wie betaal die krag, die elektrisiteit in die land? Dis die boere, dis hierdie klein salarisstrekkers, dis jong mense, dis studente, dis ou mense, dis arme mense, maar hy moet betaal net omdat hy wit is.
But even back in 91, I watched JP's disillusionment and soul-searching setting in. I think JP found the leader hard to work for. He was bad-tempered and unpredictable.
Stop. Stop, man.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Sorry.
When you take photos from me, you have to ask me, okay?
All right. Sorry.
Now you've really upset me.
What, just because we... But the thing that caused a lot of Christian folk, like Anita and JP, to doubt the leader was his extramarital affair with Janie Allen, an ex-model and journalist. I'd mentioned their affair in passing back in 91, but Janie took it a stage further when she foolishly sued Channel 4, the backers of my film. The lurid details of the leader's sex life with Janie were laid bare at the High Court in London. Witnesses were flown over from South Africa, a man was stabbed, and the world's press broadcast stories about the leader's big white bottom around the globe. Channel 4 were vindicated, and the leader was made to look a fool.
I would like to take you to Terre'Blanche and to some of the other guys.
Put us guys together.
Yes, maybe see what happens.
What do you think would happen?
Are you scared, Nick?
It doesn't make me feel comfortable, the idea.
Nothing will happen. You see how things turned out? I think you sort of enjoyed it.
JP is the proud owner of this ambulance. He works as an ambulance driver in Klerksdorp. This is Carolyn, JP's new wife. Carolyn works as a librarian in Ventersdorp, where she has her own home. She only visits JP at the weekends.
For the future, no way. This is only a passing through, as I see it. This is not our end destination. I think we have a better destination afterwards.
And what's that?
Eternal life. Or don't you believe in that?
Describe, I don't even know what it is.
You're not into religion at all. So how must I explain this now to you?
It's in you. You can't do good things to deserve it. You are born with it.
But it's like the idea of the chosen people.
That's right.
That's right.
But that's such a dangerous idea. Because everyone could think they're the chosen people. I mean, it's a...
Look, if you want to talk about religion, you've got to decide on what grounds you want to talk about it. And the only grounds I've got to talk about this is the Bible, right? Now, I've got to believe what the Bible tells me, otherwise it's useless believing in any sort of religion.
Well, what does the Bible tell you?
The Bible tells me that man was created in God's image. In other words, Adam was created in God's image.
Well, what's that got to do with being white?
Well, I'll tell you. From Adam to Noah, you can draw a direct line. And everybody that, or anything that wasn't on the ark, died off. So the only things that survived, and the only humans that survived, was on the ark. After Noah, I can draw a direct line to King David, which is the first person that is described in what he looks like. And you can go and read the description of King David, and you will see he was a white man with a reddish complexion and red hair. So the image of God that Adam was created in was white. It had this uniform on. The rest must have also been on the ark. They couldn't have been part of the humans. They must have been part of the animals. And only...
That's a very radical theory, JP.
I think so, Nick.
So they were animals.
You can call them what they like. Their name was translated. Actually,
so Adam's... What were they called in the Bible?
I can't remember the word. It's a Hebrew word. But it's been translated to Dieren van die Veld. And everywhere you read about the Dieren van die Veld in the Bible, you will see they've got human capabilities. They can touch, they can wear clothes, they can... I don't know.
Chimpanzees,
no,
gorillas.
I don't call them monkeys or chimpanzees. What I'm telling you is God created everything he created by speaking a word.
Only Adam was created by God with his hands, and he blew his spirit into Adam. And I believe the white skin is a descendant of Adam, directly.
It sounds very uncompromising.
You've upset.
No, he hasn't upset her, but we...
Unbelief. It's terrible. It's terrible.
Die kuststreken van hierdie onbekende kaap was die tuiste van een primitieve barbaarse ras. En zo het oor die barbaarse wildheid van hierdie ongerepte land voor de eerste keer een symbool van onze beschaving verrijkt. Versterkt drank het hulle spontane voorliefde gevoel, waardoor hulle bestem was om die witman zijn eerste inboorling vraagstuk te worden.
Dr. Hendrik Verwoerd, Terre'Blanche and JP's hero and political inspiration, put the apartheid policy into practice in the 1950s.
Our policy is one which is called by an Afrikaans word apartheid. And I'm afraid that has been misunderstood so often. It could just as easily, and perhaps much better, be described as a policy of good neighborliness.
White South Africa just got on with enjoying apartheid, the South Africa that JP and the leader loved. But let's just remind ourselves, our governments, Britain, America, France and West Germany, actually increased their investments once apartheid was declared. The South Africa that JP and the leader grew up in never had it so good. Under apartheid, Verwoerd set up a series of tribal homelands and forced blacks to leave the cities. 13% of the worst farmland went to the black majority. Verwoerd classified every child, woman and man by race and color. Blacks could only move away from their tribal homelands if they were employed in the white areas. Racial segregation affected every area of daily life. Sharpeville was a taste of things to come. 64 unarmed people shot dead while making a peaceful protest against the pass laws. British and American investments actually increased sixfold after Sharpeville. Companies like Hoover, Coca-Cola, Ford, General Motors, British Leyland, Courtauld, Unilever, Tate & Lyle, ICI, and banks like Chase Manhattan and Barclays. With the use of IBM computers, the apartheid regime's classifications actually became a reality. The French supplied Mirage jets, the British Buccaneers, and prohibited weapons were smuggled through Israel, even during sanctions. Nelson Mandela was seen as a terrorist by Britain and America. In 1962, he was arrested with information supplied by a CIA agent, Donald Ricard. Mandela would stay in prison for 27 years. There were several assassination attempts on Verwoerd. He was finally assassinated in 1966. His successor, Foster, interned as a Nazi in the Second World War, demonstrated his excellent taste by selecting the young leader out of 20,000 policemen to be his own personal bodyguard. Terre'Blanche also did his bit, putting down black protests as the apartheid regime became more and more oppressive.
Easy.
But the young leader found Foster too liberal. He wanted a stricter apartheid, with the blacks totally segregated in their homelands and the whites in theirs. In 1973, he left his post and formed the AWB, the Afrikaner Resistance Movement. Terre'Blanche saw the ruling party as a liberal enemy.
And I vraag for the AWB, for the KP, and the conservatives of South Africa, om nooit weer your vanhoeken te koop.
Anita was the one person who wouldn't take any shit from the leader. I really don't think she liked him very much, even back in 91.
Yes, in a sense I like him, but he's also very dominative. When he says, tells you to get up, you must get up. Now, sometimes I'm stubborn. If he says to me, get up, then I'll sit down. And he tells me to go and fetch something, I'll somewhat tell him, but I'm busy now. It's just a reaction of mine against his...
Maybe it's good for him.
Pardon?
Maybe it's good for him.
For the leader? No, it's not good. And that's what JP discovered long ago already. It's no use going against him. Rather please him, and you'll have a much more comfortable man. When you go against him, he gets more and more aggravated.
Even today, JP's identity is much more invested than Anita's in his belief in the leader and Verwoerd's vision.
The big idea was what Verwoerd had in mind. Give each guy his own country and let him rule himself. And I still think that's the only thing that can or could have worked. If you look at all these houses around you here, you've got fences between each yard. And that fence isn't the enemy, that apartheid isn't the enemy. That is just what keeps the peace. Give each guy his own. Let him rule himself. And we've got a big enough country to do that.
Yeah, but Terre'Blanche really blew his chances of a white homeland or anything else after his terrible behavior in Botswana. In the tribal homeland of Botswana.
Yeah, I don't know really what happened at the Bob thing, but there was quite a few other people involved in it as well.
In 94, Terre'Blanche sent the AWB into Botswana, one of the tribal homelands set up by Verwoerd. The AWB were propping up Mongopi, the black dictator who'd been installed by the apartheid regime. Mongopi was refusing to allow his people to take part in the upcoming South African elections. His people were now rioting and demanding their right to vote. When the rioting broke out, Mongopi had called General Vignon, former head of the South African Army and right-wing leader of the Volksfront, for help. General Vignon had his men gathered at the airport, where they were being armed by Mongopi's army, when Terre'Blanche decided to storm in uninvited.
There must be a kind of order.
We traveled through Mpumalanga near Kruger Park to visit General Vignon. General Vignon fell out so badly with Terre'Blanche over the AWB's conduct in Botswana that their right-wing Volksfront alliance would never again regain its power. General Vignon was the Afrikaner leader who Mandela most feared. He could still call on the loyalty of the white South African army. Terre'Blanche's split with General Vignon left the AWB politically isolated.
Nobody invited them. In fact, they were prohibited to go there. The chairperson of the Afrikaner Volksfront, who was then Dr. Ferdi Hartzenberg, and myself, phoned Terre'Blanche the previous afternoon saying that we're going to move in the next morning with the farmers, but saying that Mongopi has requested the AWB to remain out because of the problems that he expected.
Yes, yes! Yes, yes!
VWB behaved as though they were on a hunting trip.
They started shooting and created an atmosphere which was completely bad. And that caused a riot within the defense force of Lucas Mangopi and also within the police of Lucas Mangopi, and the whole situation became untenable.
Terre'Blanche ordered the AWB out, but they carried on firing as they left. The Bopotswana army mutinied and returned fire on the AWB convoys. This AWB Mercedes was firing into a crowd when the Bopotswana army returned fire. This incident with the blue Mercedes received worldwide coverage in the West. The irony is that it only got the attention it did because on this occasion it was three white men being executed.
We need the ambulance for this guy that's wounded.
So are you a member of the AWB?
Yeah.
You're a member of the AWB?
Yeah. I can tell you, take your life with you one second, you know that. Shit.
The execution had a devastating effect on the morale of the AWB. At the hearing for the killings, the black soldier was cleared. The new South Africa was coming. Terre'Blanche had inadvertently done Mandela an enormous favor. It was General Vignon's break from the Vox Front and his participation in the elections that spared South Africa the prospect of civil war. When we were there in 91, AWB functions were more like a social gathering, a place to dance and let your hair down. I can sonify over the broken heart. This comes for hire. Even fever just dancing in the dark. Even fever just dancing in the dark. Hey, baby! Hi! Hey! Even fever just dancing in the dark.
Do you like the atmosphere here? Yeah. It's quite nice. All the kettle and the horses together and all the people together.
When we had last seen JP in 91, it at times all seemed a bit like schoolboy fun.
It's formalin and Connie's crystals.
And what do you do with it?
You mix it together and you get tear gas. But beautiful tear gas.
No, that's good tear gas. And do you have a lot of uses for it?
Only to break up the NP meetings. That's all we use it for. That's now apart from the genuine tear gas that we steal from the army.
Hey!
And the police.
You piss!
Barry, would you like to catch a shot of this?
Nee, wacht nou man, wacht, laat ons eerst nog een dop maken. JP, jy is nou bekak. Bring the car, come on, fuck, we'll be right.
What's that, tear gas?
That's tear gas, you can...
What's wrong with diesel? Okay,
yeah, because it's not leave enough, you can't come fast, too drunk.
Do you enjoy it?
What's your...
Quite nice, isn't it?
By 94, though, moderates like JP had left the AWB. As the elections approached, which the AWB refused to recognize, only die-hard extremists remained. The leader himself became best known for falling off his horse. The AWB from this point on largely became an underground terrorist organization. They were supplied by supporters in the South African Air Force, Army and Police Force with bomb-making equipment, rifles and ammunition. The AWB is estimated let off over 120 bombs between 92 and 94. The intensity of the bombing increased in the months leading up to the election.
Sorry.
I think there will be more explosions, and I think there will be more actions if the government will ignore, according to international law, the just claim of my people to demand some land.
On the day of the South African elections in Johannesburg International Airport, an enormous bomb was let off. 31 members of the AWB were arrested that day. Nelson Mandela's own life was threatened by the AWB, who reportedly hired a hitman to kill him before the election.
Concentrate on the fact that we have made enormous progress in spite of the attempts of criminals and murderers to derail the process.
JP was very close to several of the AWB bombers, who he sees as heroes in the Boer struggle for their own homeland. JP works for this ambulance company.
We put our patient on this stretcher here. It's a self-loader, similar to those they use in America. So it's just a matter of pushing the patient into the ambulance, and there you are.
Because what I was saying before was, in a sense, you've spent your whole life looking after people, haven't you, JP?
I have, definitely.
So it's so weird to think that you could have taken part in a bombing campaign.
You know, Nick, South Africa is actually a land of big contrasts. And now I suppose you've now seen the contrast of the whole thing. I was involved. What can I say?
Ben, you could have done it.
I could have done, and I'm not sorry that I was involved. It's an experience that you, unless you live it, you won't be able to tell it to anybody else.
But those were innocent people who were killed in the bomb.
I was innocent as well.
But, I mean, I've seen some shots of the bombings, and there were all these sort of innocent people just lying in the street.
People you've
seen when you pick them up in the ambulance.
You know, Nick, the bombings came from both sides. It wasn't just from... And even the previous government were involved in bombings. That only comes to light nowadays. So, at that stage, it was the in thing. It was happening. It's something similar to all-out war. Unfortunately, this one didn't go to war so as we could have a final victor somewhere along the line.
This is the black township of Ching outside Ventersdorp. Here the blacks were confined every night after 9 p.m. when they rang the apartheid bell. It's also the place where the leader planted countless bombs.
They used to plant bombs in each and every house, in the streets, at schools, you know. So,
And what else did they do? Did they come in here and beat people?
Yeah, they did.
Can you remember it?
Yeah, I do remember it.
What do you remember? Tell me what you remember.
What I remember is we used to stay in that site, yeah? So, at next door, me and my mom's next door, yeah, they did plant a bomb. So it did explode to our house and then next door's house. So we have nothing. We didn't have a shelter to stay or something, no. We used to sleep in the grass, you know.
They blew your house up?
Yeah. I was still at school, at primary, in Tufla primary school. I was little.
And did they beat you too?
No, but the next door's grandpa, an old man, he did beat him.
They came with those horses at night. Put in those, what do they call it?
Balaclavas.
They put in those masks. Then they get inside our shacks, yeah? Beating old people.
Really?
Yeah, really? Yeah, this happened. This is a true story.
Whip sticks.
It happens. We never slept. They came inside hitting people who coming with those chasing us with those
horses.
Those horses and all those things. They come day and night, they would be beating us. Understand? We've been beaten by them. And you know what they did? And then they even make those, they put also bombs. These explosions ones. Right in that new extension there was a bomb. Even someone's leg was cut off because of the
hand.
And the hand because of that bomb. You see? That's what happened before. But now currently we are also saying that this is the time for us, né, to sit down and reconcile. We are ready to reconcile. You know what? We are victims and then white people are the culprits. But now what they are doing, they don't want to come to us. We are saying, guys, come on. Yes, you did this to us. That's why the former president, Nelson Mandela, said, it's time for us to forgive and forget.
Nelson Mandela avoided civil war by spreading this gospel of peace and reconciliation to both sides. Other members of the right, such as General Vignon, had an excellent working relationship with Mandela. The AWB remained totally racist. This is the way they treated an American reporter covering the elections.
I'm a reporter, you know. I came here to report a story.
And what happened from the first instance?
I don't have the slightest idea.
Nothing.
Somebody came and said, you know, I should leave.
The election on April the 27th, 94, was the first multiracial vote ever in South Africa. There was a massive turnout, people voting for the very first time, some queuing for days. AWB members harassed people at several voting stations. Foreign journalists covering the elections were beaten up. De Klerk conceded defeat in Pretoria. The ANC had won just under 2/3 of the vote.
Of private property to them. And if it is necessary to fight, then we'll fight the communists because we will never accept the communists or the ANC government of South Africa.
The main event for the AWB after the elections was 34 bombing suspects appearing in a Joburg court. Those arrested included the AWB executive secretary, Terre'Blanche's chief of staff and his head of operations. 22 of the accused were former South African special forces with explosives training.
Yeah!
it's a hard thing for me, all my friends in jail locked up with long sentences. I hope something can happen to have them released.
What happened to them exactly?
There were three, four of them that was locked up together for the same type of bombings. And they got different sentences depending on which role they played. But my big friend Cliffy Barnard, he got about 7 life sentences. See, what we did, we really believed in. I think from our previous encounter, you know that I was sort of romantically involved with the revolution.
Good morning.
Hello.
Where have you been?
Just visiting next door, and the kids have been swimming there a little bit. I just want to put it on the wire.
Anita likes to teach her grandchildren about Africana history and traditions.
They love ketchup.
But do you also teach them to be tolerant and accepting of the black?
Yes. And I think they grow up with that, meeting the mates at school and playing with them and doing things together, they will get used to that.
Mm.
But it's still funny to us.
It's funny.
You know, when you visit a friend, a black friend of a schoolboy come in and say, "Marach tani, marach uam," you don't, you know, it feels funny.
What does that mean?
Good afternoon, uncle, and good afternoon, auntie. So, you know, you're not... it's funny for them to say uncle and auntie to us.
Do you like that, or...?
Yes, it shows respect still, and there's no offence towards that.
But it's more equal.
It's more equal.
And does
he's
that...
got the ability to greet you, and he don't call you boss and missus anymore because you're not his employer.
And do you like that change?
I think that's the way forward. That's how things are going. Doesn't depend on my liking or not.
After the election, the leader himself retreated to his farm with his horse and his dogs, while the AWB offices in Ventersdorp closed down due to falling membership. But remember, although Mandela was president, the leader still had his hometown of Ventersdorp tied up. He still had his own private police force leased out to the council and dished out his own kind of justice. It was 96, and John, who works at this service station, had reported seeing a white boy breaking into the chemist's. Terre'Blanche rode up at 4:30 a.m. on his horse with his dog to teach John a lesson.
It was me, Eugene, and the dog in the toilet. He locked me in the toilet inside. And then he said to me, "John, you know what?" I said, "No, Mren, I don't know what is my problem." He said, "Your problem is why? Why you say the police, that guy you have broken here is a white guy?" I said, "Mren, I have seen the white guy broken toilets." He said, "No, you know, the white guy doesn't broke. The guy who is broken is only black people." I said, "No, Morena, that one I have seen is a white guy. It's a small one. He broke into the table." He said to me, "No, you talk lie. The white guy doesn't broke." And then he coming and take me like this way. Say to me, "John, you see my eyes? You open his eyes." I said, "Yeah, Maran, I see your eyes." Say to me, "It's the first time and it's the last time, John. It's the first time and the last time you see my eyes. I'm going to kill you today." I tried to take his sense out to me. But he said to the dog, "Saldana, bite. Saldana, bite him. Saldana, bite him." The dog tried to bite, but he bite me. This first bite here. And then one is that one, one is that one. Then he answered. I know his dogs is trying to bite guys here at the front. You see? I try to put my hands like this way. The doggy want to bite me. All the guys, black people, white people, is afraid for Eugene. If Eugene come to this, run away.
The leader was also drinking heavily. In the same year, in a drunken state, he beat his night watchman, poor Mashabi, who lives here in the township of Ching. Terre'Blanche beat him so badly that Paul was left in a coma and now remains paralyzed down one side.
En heeft hij geld gekregen van meneer Terre'Blanche?
Heeft hem nog niet betaald.
This is the 97 court appearance of Eugene Terre'Blanche for the attempted murder of Paul Mashabi. There was increasing black opposition, but Terre'Blanche was protected by a sympathetic police force still controlled by whites. The leader received a very sympathetic hearing from a white judiciary. He got a combined sentence of 1 year for John's assault and 6 years for the attempted murder of Paul. However, the leader appealed on the same day and was never admitted to prison.
Ek is onskuldig, my kind. En ek glo in almagtige God. Ek verwag dat ek hier vry sal uitstap. Ek het maar net 'n man hospitaal toe geneem.
In 2000, the leader was suspected of the murder of Venderstop's first black mayor.
Now we're fine.
Strangely though, Anita is much more sympathetic to the leader now than she was in 91.
You're very fond of Mr. Terre'Blanche.
Not that we are friends or visiting, things like that, but I think he walked the road and he also, the sun shine on his head as well, just like on everybody else's. He also needs a space, and he did try to wake up people, maybe try to save the money or the country, although it was not the right time, through the right channels. But it was good fun while it was lasting.
But I mean, when you hear that he went into the townships and beat people up with his horses and his men, innocent people in the township, in Ventersdorp even, or beat blacks up who were walking in the middle of the town after 8 o'clock, it's not so much fun.
No, and I don't agree with things like that. But I don't think he really, I don't know, there's two sides of a story, if it was really innocent people or was it, you know, Tsotsis who was looking for
What about the killing of the mayor, Mayor Mashi?
That was his own people for money. They discovered he won some money, or because he got his money as the mayor, and one of his own friends or somebody killed him. That's what I heard. Greed.
Mayor Mashi started a big rebuilding program to clear the squatter camps. He also took the brave decision to cancel the leader's security contract with the council. 2 weeks later, Mayor Mashi disappeared.
Till recently, a security firm of AWB leader Eugene Terre'Blanche guarded the municipal offices in Ventersdorp. After a recent spate of fires and burglaries at the offices, the contract with the firm was terminated. Now rumor has it that the AWB is involved in the disappearance of the mayor.
This absurd. Om my buite op my plaas te beskuldig dat ek 'n burgemeester so ontvoer. Ek jy sien ek het nie werk vir 'n burgemeester hier op die plaas.
Mayor Mash's body was eventually found next to his car in this field. His cousin was convicted of the murder, even though 83 witness statements indicated that he was elsewhere. We talked to the current mayor of Ventersdorp, Mr. Umbolala, who was certain there was a conspiracy.
It is claimed that it was a robbery. But how do you rob a person? How do you kill a person? Don't take the car, just put it in the field, and in the car there is money. His money was found there. The cell phone was found there. And his pistol, the gun was also there, just under the seat when the car was found in the field. So you can't say it's a robbery if nothing has been taken. But in court, it was presented that way. I think the court process took about 6 minutes. Everything was over, as if it wasn't a murder case.
And was the judge a black judge or?
He was white.
In 2001, the leader's appeals ran out and he was sentenced to 6 years for the charges of attempted murder and assault. His numerous charges of bombing and acts of terrorism were also taken into account. There were celebrations, but no one knew that Terre'Blanche would in fact only serve 3 years. He was released in 2004. It was an outrage for the black community. But even then, the leader received preferential treatment in prison. Many of the white warders were AWB sympathizers, and Terre'Blanche was housed in the prison hospital. Later, he had the comfy job running the farm in Rooigrond prison. This is Ventersdorp now, but it wasn't so long ago that Ventersdorp under the leader was like this. The question is, how much has the new South Africa actually changed Ventersdorp? In 91, the Ventersdorp High School, seen here, was strictly whites only. The white school was very defensive. In 2005, the Ching Township Secondary School of 1,000 pupils is still 100% black. There isn't even a single white teacher.
I think there is very little changes that has happened in the education in Ventersdorp, because there are still schools that are still for the white people and schools for the black people. So racially, we have not yet integrated in education.
There was an attempt to integrate some colored kids into the white high school, but it went horribly wrong.
And
the principal of this school called the couple and expelled her from school.
Why are you so frightened of being on filmed?
I'm afraid because they say
If we talk, they are going to eat us. So I must go back to school. So when I talk here, they are going to kill me there. So that's why I'm scared to talk about them.
Are you frightened of Mr. Terre'Blanche?
No, I'm not afraid about Mr. Terre'Blanche because he doesn't do anything to me. I'm afraid of that white people who are there.
The students were in fact referring to the teacher, J.J. Bota, who was fired for calling a student a kafir.
They call us kafirs.
This is a new high school principal who refused to be interviewed. Numbers of black students attending the school has actually dropped amidst continuing reports of racist teachers. All lessons are still taught in Afrikaans. There isn't a single black teacher, and not one black student has completed his studies successfully and gone on to college. It's on the farms that are all white-owned, where there's been absolutely no change, and conditions are feudal. On July the 11th, 2004, the leader was released from prison. He refused to apologize to Paul or John, the men he brutally assaulted.
I was never wrong to honor my heritage and to love my people and to be there when they call.
So do you think you could arrange a meeting with Terre'Blanche?
I'll do my best. I can't promise you nothing, Nick. Because the relationship that was there between me and him doesn't exist anymore.
Why do you think that changed?
I got fed up with it. Remember after when you guys were here, I started getting fed up with those Okies. So I just fell to pieces. We speak to each other, we're friendly, but that close relationship isn't there anymore.
Mm.
But I'll do my best. I'll speak to him.
And you think he's changed as a man?
I really do. He's grown meek. And I don't think the restrictions, the parole restrictions, has anything to do with that. I think he's had a change of heart. And I know you're going to show it to him, so it doesn't matter. But I do think he's had a change of heart.
In what way?
I have to believe that he's had a religious, what do you call it?
Epiphany.
Yeah, I think so.
Why, what did he say?
No, it's nothing he said. I can see it. Mm-hmm. It's nothing he really said about it. But being jailed in Africa isn't fun. Whether it's for a criminal offense or whether it's for a political offense, it's not fun. So I can understand what happened to him. To switch off your thing. You're going too deep into things.
Too deep?
Too deep.
In what way?
Just cut your thing too.
Please arrange.
Yeah, let's stay outside.
Yeah, let's stay outside. Let's stay outside.
Come on, Nick.
Come here, JP. I want to ask you a couple more questions.
I was going to get you. You see, God's going to get you.
Do you think God's going to get me?
Come on.
Daar is ek nie verlore. Daar word ek nooit eensaam. Daar lê my klein tydspore.
daar skree die duivel Koran.
I learned that since he'd left prison, the leader liked to write poetry out at his farm.
Witgerypte wintervleie, suikerbosse van alle kante, alles bly my dierbaar.
I wondered if he really had changed and if he was now preaching at a black gospel church.
Van Messina en Louis Trigard.
It had been so tricky getting to the leader. We even thought of posing as beggars in front of his local spa store or breaking down in front of his drive. The Poetry Society, who made this film, are about to release a book of the leader's poems. After weeks of phone calls, Rita convinced the leader that we want to interview him about his forthcoming book. We arranged to meet him at his home in Ventersdorp. Very anxious and driving far too fast, we drive into a speed trap and get pulled over. What do you think of Eugene Terre'Blanche?
Of?
Eugene Terre'Blanche.
Our own Eugene Terre'Blanche.
Yeah.
I don't even want to talk about that.
You're a monster.
You don't want to talk about a monster?
I don't even want to talk about that.
Okay,
but at least you can laugh now.
Yeah, but I think it's okay now because he learned something.
I explained what had happened the last time we were 5 minutes late for the leader.
Where were you the time when you must when you should be arrived at my place? Where were you?
Well, I think we were actually 5 minutes late, Mr.
Yes, 5 minutes is enough, man. Where were you then at 12:15? Tell me.
We were immediately let off and wished the best of luck. Have you got a message to give to Eugene?
No, I don't have a message for Eugene.
No message?
Yeah, just tell Eugene to be nice, it's okay. That's the message.
Goodbye. In order to see if Eugene had really changed and felt genuine remorse, I needed to get beyond our own terrible relationship. Putting on an accent slightly to the west of Hugh Grant, I decided to go incognito. This is the leader's heavily fortified house, all the bars and wire meshing are new since I was last here. I was beginning to feel slightly unwell.
Mr. Tomas was suggesting doing an interview outside to be dark.
I think it will be better. He said, you must decide, lady, whether you want to take it there in the front
or the back.
Part of the yard or in the back.
Can I have a look?
It's a different garden.
Shall I walk through the place while you guys?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, let me walk you through.
Yeah, now, there's a basket to be drawn.
That's right.
You can't even miss it.
That's 100%.
But later on, I'll make the Engelse dames verschrikkelijk jaloers als ze mijn broek daar.
Ik ga niks vertellen.
I'd always wanted to look around the leader's house. Strangely, Eugene has invited us to come with him to church on Sunday, where he's giving the sermon.
Do I look like a silly Englishman? Very silly. A bit worried, they've all gone away and...
Technically, that's all that it's about. Yeah. Is that we need to make so sure that we can't do any political questions whatsoever, just for the parole.
Sure, at least
past December. Excellent.
Okay. I wonder where he keeps the horse, where he used to batter everyone in the township with.
So where are you from, sir?
I'm from London too.
Oh, from London. Are you enjoying South Africa? Change weather.
It's a very welcome change.
Is it the first time that you've...
It's the second time now.
I didn't think I'd remind him of the first time.
You are just taking over. Who the hell do you think you are?
Do you find nature very reassuring from all the changes and so on that have happened here in the last few years?
Well, the fact is, it is good to see that nobody can change nature. And that shows you the greatness of God.
There was no way that this was the dog I've been hearing about. I asked the leader where his dog was.
No, I told my friends last night I've had a flat tire, you know. So I left my van at a friend's house 6-7 kilometers from here. But I left my dog there, a German Shepherd, on the van, you know, because it was impossible to put him in a car.
Yes.
And this morning they tried to change the wheel. They took off the flat wheel, and when they tried to fetch the spare wheel, the Shepherd attacked them. And now he's still there, waiting. He's guarding that van of me. It's unbelievable, in a strange place, in a strange yard. But he realized it's my van, and they have to safeguard that wheel.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Really, really loyal dog.
It's a loyal dog, yeah. But you know, one of our great poets said, the more I look at my neighbor, the more I look at my neighbor, yeah, the more I look at my dog, the less I think of my neighbor. So, a dog is so loyal.
What a dog.
Slan, slan, teen die tralie muur, die blikbekers.
He then read out great swathes of his poetry about God and his time in prison that we decided not to include.
I was in a prison where, it was a prison where the murderers and the rapers were held.
Yes.
Especially the murderers and the rapers. I slept two blokes guilty of murder next to me, and a rapist on top of me.
Do you think that prison changed your poetry a great deal?
Well, I think it makes me, makes it richer, you know, because I am richer now. I've grown myself in my soul and my heart. I am what I am. Maybe I'm saying I don't care a damn, but the fact is, I'm satisfied with myself. And I'm not ashamed for nothing.
It's fine. So sorry. Do you think maybe we could come to the church?
No problem.
No problem? No problem.
Tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, Rosettenville, Johannesburg.
You know, we saw Mr. Terre'Blanche over the weekend.
Did you? Did you speak to him?
Yeah.
What did he say?
I don't think he knew it was me.
Oh. Is he willing to have a...
We did an interview.
Did you do an interview?
That's very nice. He read us some poems.
That's very nice, Nick. I don't know how you did it. You wear a mask or something?
I wore a hat.
Okay.
And a big pair of glasses, and I sweated and trembled a lot.
He didn't endanger you in any way, did he?
No, he read some poems out and said that he was a changed man.
Okay. You believe him?
Do you?
You asked me that the other day. I told you I believe him. Do you, at any stage now, see him as the leader of a weerstandsbeweging? You think he might be the guy that will carry us through the problems we have at this stage?
What do you think?
I don't think so.
Anita's life has changed. It now centers around her grandchildren and her cats.
I realize that I don't need a man to feel happy, and I can do everything myself. So now even the loneliness doesn't make any difference to me. I can stay at home and do things and put my nice music and do some sewing and knitting and everything for the whole day, or visit friends or whatever. I'm fine now. Hello?
Hello, my baba.
Kom hier so. Wys vir hulle jou vet magie. Net jou vet magie. Ja, en hier sy naampie. I put her name tag on. And at the back, my telephone number. So when they walk away, I can find them, or somebody can find them and phone me. But him and Kafferkie did not walk. They just stay with me.
Everything started fine with Eugene at the church. But then I got the feeling the leader was checking me out. I wasn't sure if I was being paranoid, but the leader and his daughter seemed to be comparing notes. I think it was the leader's daughter who recognized me. I had that peculiar, creepy feeling of being talked about.
Job sit tussen die vullis. Job het soos vullis geword. En Job se sere het gestink. Job het gefrot, sodat die honde gekom het en sy sere gelek het. Die honde het nie gekom om sy sere te lek, omdat hulle hom jammer gekry het nie. Die honde het gewag dat hy moet dood. Die honde wou hom vreet. Die honde het agter die vrot van sy sere geloop.
Things were definitely more frosty when we did a shot backstage.
Die honde het agter God se liefling geloop om hom op te vreet, want hy het gestink.
Jy irriteer die mense, by dit was nie 'n ooreenkoms nie. Want my hande was so vastgemaak en my voete. My hande was met ysterskakels vastgemaak en my voete met ysterskakels, maar sy hande was oopgestrek deur die kruis en is met ysterpenne deurboor geslaan. Sy voete was vastgeslaan, Jesus van Nazareth, die Seun van God. Waarom word ek na Papotatswana geneem, die een enkele plek waar die AWB in wapenkonfrontasie met die ANC was in Papotatswana? Daar waar mense vermoor is, daar waar konfrontasie was, word ek soontoe geneem, geboei. Wat is die boodskap wat die Satan en die magte vir my wil gee? Hier gaan ons jou hou, hier in Papotatswana. Hier sluit ons jou toe. Hier moet jy vir jare bly. My vrou en my kind alleen. My plaas verwaarloos. My vee alleen.
But then when I called afterwards to arrange our next meeting.
Oh, yeah. Now,
yes.
No, sir. I think I gave you enough. Please, let me go now. Leave it there. I think you got enough material to do a story. Bye.
Kom, Fitzes. Kom, my honne. Kom. Kom, ons gaan in.
It was time to say goodbye to Fetzers and JP.
Come, my brock. Come.
Come on, okay.
See? Devoted.
Oof. Don't you think dogs are wonderful things?
I suppose they can't disagree with you.
No, they never do. They're the only ones that are really glad when they see somebody they like. They don't lie. And they don't pretend.
And they could, for all you know, be a member of the AWB.
Yeah, but who will know?
Go on, have a good drag from that cigarette. Before.
Would you like to see that as well?
Here's a man who's had 3 heart bypass operations and he's still dragging it down.
Yeah, well, thanks to you, this would be one good deed.
Anyone would think you might be self-destructive.
Well, it is. It is self-destructing. Don't you think that?
In an effort to curb JP's 60-a-day intake, we made an appointment for him to see a hypnotist.
Do you think that guy would be able to help?
I don't know. You've got a bit of a mangled maze.
I think so.
Well, that's what we'll find out about.
Okay. Is this what Anita has been talking about last night?
Anita, no.
Oh, okay.
Do you think we just talk about you?
No, but coming up with an idea like you just mentioned, it must come from a...
Does Anita think you have a mangled maze?
I think so. Fetzers? It looks like I won the battle with the ants, though.
Bye-bye. Lekker slaap.
On our last evening, Chief Nurse Anita invited us to join her on the night shift at the local hospital. Previously all white, it now serves the whole community.
I should give another around 25 milligrams. And then the temperature is 37.2, pulse is 105, BP 132, 78.
We've got him on the monitor, checking his blood pressure, everything. Should be fine now.
Je moet roebalen. En als jy stilhou, ek gaat vir jou die sweet gee. As jy nie stilhou nie, ek gee vir jou nie sweet nie.
She's got sweets for the children, always.
Sorry?
Sorry? Sorry? Nou, voetevolk moest me altijd bekie. Septies. Wanneer wat het om gesnap?
Een glas.
Big boy. Maar die goed kom na môre.
Môre lief wat? Dit gaan glad nie goed met meneer Erasmus nie.
Dis hy. Ja, nie wat dokter is nie nodig dat jy kom nie. Ah.
Ons nou doen net dis hy.
Come on!
how I love you, yeah.